when you have a hybrid dog, it's always interesting to look at the stats of the contributing breed. It can also be eye-opening to see side-by-side difference between Maltipoo and Toy Poodle. So, in this video, we will cover following topics. Appearance difference. The size and weight of a Maltipoo depends which characteristic they inherit from their parent breed. They may stand anywhere between 8 to 14 inches tall and can weigh between 5 to 20 pounds. Toy Poodle is a very small dog. They stand at a maximum of 10 inches and weigh between 6 to 9 pounds. A male with weight slightly more than a female. Grooming difference between Toy Poodle and Maltipoo. Toy Poodle can be quite tricky to groom because instead of the double layer of fur that most breeds have, they have a single layer of hair. The difference is that fur will grow to a certain point and then shed out. But hair on the other hand keeps growing longer and longer. And when it does fall out, it becomes intertwined with the surrounding hair. And this is why they are one of the only small hypoallergenic dogs. Another side, Maltipoo is generally easy dog to take care of, although they do not to be groomed often. This is because of their beautiful coat. Whether they have the curly coat of a poodle or the longer coat of the Maltese, you will need to brush their fur almost every day. Maltipoo coat will need to be professionally groomed every 6 weeks, so to keep them looking their best. Training difference between Maltipoo and Toy Poodle. Maltipoo is a dog that is easy to train. You must be patient and consistent with them, but they will pick up basic commands very easily. You should always use positive reinforcement with your Maltese Poodle hybrid. This includes verbal praise and treats. Never use punishment with them because they are so devoted to their owners. They will not understand and be hurled and confused, which can lead to destructive behaviors. Another side, poodles are known to being very intelligent breed, which makes training easy. This is another reason they are such a popular dog, because they are easy to train even if you have never trained a dog before. This toy breed does well with positive reinforcement while training. Also, due to their intelligence, they require a lot of mental stimulation. Toy poodles do not like to be left alone and will want to play with you. If you need to go out, give them a toy that will keep their brain busy while you are away so they don't exhibit destructive behaviors. Health issues between Maltipoo and Toy Poodle. Unfortunately, as with any dog, the Maltipoo and Toy Poodle also develop some health issues. The three main health problems that you may see in your Toy Poodle is progressive retinal atrophy, hip dysplasia, and Addison disease. Another side, Maltipoo have developed four major health issues, included white shaker syndrome, patellar luxation, epilepsy, and progressive retinal atrophy. Food and diet difference between Maltipoo and Toy Poodle. As they are a small breed, the Maltipoo does not require a lot of food. The general rule is 40 calories per pound of body weight per day, which can average out to around 200 calories or 1 cup of food a day. However, you should always check the bag of the food packet to see the exact amount of the particular food you should be feeding your pup based on their size. On the other side, the Toy Poodle is much smaller than the standard or miniature poodle. So, they have smaller food requirements. You should be feeding them 200 calories a day, split into two meals. You should always make sure the food you feed them is high quality and full of the nutrients they need, including protein, fat, and carbohydrates. Exercise difference between Toy Poodle and Maltipoo. Toy Poodle have a lot of energy, so exercise is important. But because of their small size, their exercise needs are smaller than many dogs. If you over-exercise your Toy Poodle, then you may end up harming their smaller limbs. On the other side, Maltipoo is certainly more of an indoor breed. But this does not mean they don't like to exercise. These pups should be getting between 30 to 40 minutes of exercise every day. However, this doesn't mean you need to walk them for that length of time every day. This can be split over games, walks, and run to keep them engaged and entertained. Lifespan difference between Maltipoo and Toy Poodle. The life expectancy of Toy Poodle is relatively long. These dogs can be expected to live anywhere between 12 to 15 years. On other side, the life expectancy of Maltipoo is around 12 to 16 years.